1935, the great new French luxury liner Normandie arrives in New York after a triumphal maiden voyage. She captures the blue ribbon for the fastest Atlantic crossing on her first trip, 4 days and 11 hours from Southampton. The uproarious welcome augurs well for the new pride of the French merchant marine. The Normandie seems destined to rule as queen of the seas for many years to come. But the Normandie's reign was brief. 4 years later, the war in Europe broke out and she was tied up in New York. In 1942, she was acquired by the Navy and conversion work began. Then disaster struck. Fire, sparked by an acetylene torch, swept through the proud ship. Thousands of workmen fled for their lives as firemen from all parts of New York and neighboring cities fought the fire around the clock. Tens of thousands of tons of water were poured into the holds. Still the fire burned, and the ship began to list despite the efforts of mothering tugs to keep it upright. The death of a queen. Now the $60 million luxury liner lies on her side, mortally stricken. Just 6.5 years after that proud maiden voyage, the Normandie comes to the end of a short yet memorable career. Salvage efforts began a few months later, and a special camera recorded the slow righting of the Normandie. It was a multi-million dollar project aimed at putting the vessel into service as a troop transport. However, the need for the ship did not warrant the cost, and the great sea queen was towed to the scrap heap. The saga of the ill-starred Normandie was at an end.